disagree with you. They're gonna think that their opinion is the best opinion out there, whether that's starting a business, doing something that's physically challenging. So I just started doing a triathlon, and of course everyone came out of the woodwork saying, dude, you can't, either you can't do it, you're not gonna be able to finish, or it's just not a good idea. So just go into that. I'll just tell you the backstory. When I started my business, it was, I forgot the year, it's 5 years ago. So it's 2014, 2013, actually at Thanksgiving, I brought it up and I just said it to my uncle. I wasn't even preparing to just drop the news, I'm starting my own business, but I just said it. And then my uncle out of nowhere just freaking yelled it out. And I have a big family. There was like 35 people there and he goes, hey, Rita. Rita's my mom's name. And he goes, Rita, they're brother and sister. You know your son's starting a business? And then everyone turns around and then you have to defend it. I wasn't even looking to defend it at the time. I was just saying, yeah, I'm looking to actually potentially go out on my own. And it just turned into this, just snowballed. And then the whole conversation, everyone's looking at you to see if you can confidently defend your decision, which I couldn't. So everyone's like, you're probably gonna fail. You're probably gonna have to go back and go to a big company. And at that time, it kind of struck me as weird because, you know, there's two ways to think about it. One, which is they want the best for you. And then the second thing is that they might not be pushing themselves. So they're looking at you and they're saying, well, I'm not pushing myself, so I don't want you to push yourself because it makes me look bad. So just understand that when you go public and you're gonna be doing something physically challenging, something outside of someone's comfort zone, maybe you're traveling, maybe you're quitting your job, maybe you're, whatever you're doing, just know you're gonna get a lot of pushback. The first thing, when you are starting a business, and this is mine, it may not be for you guys, is that I thought that the size of my business was in direct relationship with how successful I am. The first thing is, don't overhire. I overhired. I thought, well, shit, let's bring on 4 people. Let's bring on 5 people. So I just brought on all these people and I overhired and I wasn't ready. And I thought that the amount of people was in direct relationship with the success that I'm having. In other words, the amount of profit I'm gonna be able to make, the amount of net income that I'm gonna take home, is that the amount of people equals just hard work. You know, amount of people equals there's gonna be productivity. The first thing is, and I'll tell you why. And obviously, since I had like an entrepreneurial streak, but this actually came to a head. So one of my clients that I really respect, he actually raised $3.2 billion and he got a portion of that. Obviously, not something where he made himself like, he was a millionaire, but not like, whoa, kind of millionaire. And he always said that, like, so I went to him when I was starting my business and I went around and I said, hey, listen, you started your own business. Do you give, what's your inkling on any kind of piece of advice that I can get? So he actually mentioned, and he kept on asking me, as I'm starting, and then maybe even 2 months in and 3 months in, he goes, how many people you have working for you? How many, even today, 5 years later, he keeps on asking, how many people you have working for you? Like, the amount of people equals success is not true. So you have to go through some of these just labels where you believe something and then you're like, actually, that's not true. So number one is, don't overhire. Number two is, don't overspend. So this is a massive deal when it comes to getting VC money. Obviously, venture capital. So essentially you get infused with 10 million, 50 million, 100 million, or even $1,000. And then you take that money and then you immediately spend all of it. That's a problem. And the reason being is that you're not actually putting it potentially towards something that's gonna make you a return on the investment. That money sometimes goes to a blowout launch party or the most expensive computers or the most expensive workspace. So essentially I took all the money that I had saved up. I almost went out of business within like 4 months because I got MacBooks for everyone. I got the most expensive office space. It was a 4-person, 5-person overlooking the Empire State Building. It was sick. My overhead exploded and I was like, fuck. I was like, I gotta bring in business immediately, which leads me into that. So don't overspend, go diligently. Just spend enough to make a return on the investment. Don't do what Gary Vaynerchuk talks about, which is put all of your money into Facebook ads and everything else. For me, in real estate, it's all about prospecting. It's all about going out and getting getting business. Because real estate, honestly, that's good marketing, but that's not gonna bring in sales. And I've noticed that over the past couple of years, which actually goes into the third thing, is have systems in place and have a workflow for the people that you bring on, okay? So when you decide to bring people on, don't just say, well, I need an assistant, or I need a marketer, I need a CIO, chief investment officer, or chief technology officer, or CFO, or whatever the case is that you have to have a, this is the best way to do it, is that you have a list of things that you want to do and you're good at doing, and then you have a list of things that you don't want to do, and there's a list of things that you're not good at. So you hire out, or you just eliminate all the things that you're either not good at doing. In other words, for me, it's not design and making thumbnails and social media and video editing. I thought I was good, but I'm not, okay? And it's very time intensive, and that's not what I'm good at. That's not my bread and butter. So you have to understand that what you're good at and only you can do is what you need to continue doing. Anything else, you need to hire out, whether that's a virtual assistant, whether that's someone that's part-time, whether that's an intern, whatever the case is, but you have to have set systems. So when they walk in every single day, they know exactly what they're gonna do, have a list, and just say, this is what you're gonna do every single day. Have a system in place. So when I get a new listing, this checklist needs to happen. We need to order the floor plan. We need to order the photographs. We need to put this on the MLS. We gotta make sure that the owner is aware that the video is live, that we're on social media. We have to send out the newsletter. We have to get the print material ready for the open house. We have to schedule the open house. All these things that need to happen that you don't want to do. So in other words, our virtual assistant does that. You just give that to them. Have a system in place. Four, leading from the front. This is probably the biggest thing that leaders and managers and people in position do not understand at all. Politicians, people in corporate, parents, siblings, people in relationships, it's everywhere. People don't lead from the front. So here's an example. Someone that's in the fitness industry that's out of shape. Dude, you're in the fitness industry. You're telling me how to take care of my body, my nutrition, my waking hours, what I should be doing, how often I should jog or run or stand or sleep, and you're not even doing it. You're not leading from the front. Or someone that's a social media influencer and they have 10,000 people that are following them, or the person that's like, I am a social media marketer, yet they don't have anyone, their feed isn't good. It doesn't matter. I was not leading from the front. So what I was doing was I was just telling them, this is what you need to do, but I wasn't doing it. Here's an example. So I would tell them, you need to prospect for business, yet I was not prospecting for business. I was telling them that you need to come in at a certain time. I was sort of coming in at that time, but I might have been tired, or I might have been hungover, or I was telling them to eat healthy and go to the gym, yet I was kind of a fraud on that, where I wouldn't show up all the time and I would not be going to the gym, and I would say that energy and sleep and everything else is paramount, but I wasn't actually doing it. You have to lead from the front. If you're in a relationship and you say, we should go to the gym, and you're not making any effort to go to the gym, why would that person go? You have to do what you need to do, and it will rub off. And I'll just give you this before I move on to the bonus one, which is when you start doing something, okay, the biggest thing that you're gonna notice is that people are gonna question. Then they're gonna say, I don't think you're gonna be able to finish. You're not gonna keep on doing that, whether that's going to the gym, reading, starting a business, prospecting, whatever the case is, you know, approaching that pretty girl, asking that guy out, you're not gonna continue doing that. But when you continue doing that, that's when they're motivated, because they question. They try and drag you down. And then when you keep on going, they go, oh damn, they're serious about this. And then they might go to the gym. They might start acting more positive. They might start saving more money. And the last thing is, when things go wrong, so in this case, so number four was leading from the front. Okay, if you're not doing it, you can't expect anyone else to do it. If you've never done it, don't expect anyone in the company to ever do it. Taking accountability is the bonus one. I would blame them. Why are you not prospecting? Why are you not eating healthy? But really what I was doing was putting myself, just looking at myself in the mirror and just saying, dude, why are you not prospecting? Why are you not waking up early? Why are you not going to the gym? There was no accountability on my end. You know, I was accountable for some things, but I was telling them to do things, then getting mad at them, then blaming them. Guess who hired them? I did. Guess who hired them? You did. So you have to understand that it's your problem, whether you like it or not. So you have to take full accountability and be solution-oriented. I hope that helps. If you guys have any questions around this, definitely leave in the comments below. I would say if you are looking to start a business, it is not as sexy as Gary Vaynerchuk talks about. There's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears when it comes to bringing a business, keeping business, competition, keeping on top of technology, obviously social media and video and marketing and advertising and sales and everything that goes along with it, the financial systems and obviously getting regular systems if you start bringing people on and managing people. There's just a whole host of things that happen. Gary brings it out like it's like this easy thing that everyone should be doing it. No, not everyone should be doing it because you have to be a very forward-thinking kind of person. It takes a very special type of person. But the second in line, the COO, the Sheryl Sandberg, the person, the Wozniak to Job, or what's his name to Bill Gates, is exactly who you need, okay? Because that person actually implements it to the company. You have the visionary, and then you have the COO who takes care of the day-to-day tasks and say, hey, listen, Steve, we're going a little bit fast. I know you want to innovate and everything else, but we can't actually implement that in this quarter. We have to push it out 2 or 3 quarters. Hope that helps. Subscribe to the video. If you guys have any questions, obviously leave in the comments below. I'm going to be going over a couple more book reviews. If you guys haven't seen that, that's probably one of the better videos I'm going to be making. I go live and I talk about all the books that I read. I essentially go through the 400 and whatever, 500 books that I ordered on Amazon, and then maybe I'll probably go into Audible. So have an amazing day. Talk to you guys soon.